In this video, I explore elevators and transit in Buffalo, New York, in the USA. While this was kind of an interesting city to explore, unfortunately, all the tall buildings here were the most restricted, so I wasn't able to get up most of them. And because of timing, I wasn't able to get on some of the elevators I could have filmed. So here I am at Buffalo Metropolitan Center, and let's get into the video. First, I go to the ticket machines and buy myself what's called a Metco card, which is a day pass for the NFTA. Before I do anything, along I go to Tim Hortons to get myself some lunch. I always sort of wondered what Tim Hortons was like here versus what it was like at home, and while it is very similar, the menu and the signage are slightly different. And now I explore Buffalo's public transit system. And since I'm near a bus stop, let's get on a bus.
Chippewa Street.
Explore the NFTA Metrorail. Usually the train goes between Erie Canal Harbor and University, but because of track construction on the one side of the track, they had a single car train running on the other side of the track going from Church and Erie Canal Harbor. And then they had three car trains going between Church and University that ran about every 20 minutes. Another thing about the Metrorail is the stations they have on the street level, they call free fare zones, so you don't have to pay to get on if you're just riding the train above ground. But if you're riding the train underground, you have to have a proof of payment to be on the train. So let's ride.
Yeah.
And here's what a typical elevator looks like in the NFTA Metro. And here is the hotel I am staying in, which features a scenic elevator. Now I take a ride on one of NFTA's older model of buses.
Now approaching Park Street and Pearl Street.
now, I look for some elevators to ride, and along I go to City Hall, where they have some interesting old elevators that have been modernized with innovation fixtures. And here is a view of the observatory.
You can see Niagara Falls over there.
Back downstairs and along I go to the low-rise elevators.
You too.
Now I go to elevators at a parking garage attached to the family court, which has innovation fixtures.
Going down.
And along I go to the Asperger Ramp parking garage, where they have some Dover Impulse tractions.
Thank you.
And now I go to this white building, but it was restricted so I wasn't able to get on the elevators. And now I go to the Garden Inn Hotel, where once again I was not able to get up the elevators as they were restricted.
This elevator serving only hotel floors at this time. Please exit and use another elevator. This elevator serving only hotel floors at this time. Please exit and use another elevator.
Oh, well.
And now I go to the Guarantee Building, where they have some modernized elevators that still have the original shaft. However, I was once again told that these elevators were restricted.
Before I even press the button.
Going down, Mark?
1825, they move out?
Yeah. I think for a second, yeah, they're out, they moved out.
Yeah, I had a next day or later, but I just want to go down here a moment. I'll take it back.
Okay.
Just taking a peek out here. Thinking of my next 37 stops and where I'm going.
Always.
I go to the Hyatt Regency, where they have some similar elevators with an interesting touchscreen.
Thank you.
And now I go to the Buffalo Erie County Public Library, where they have a modern elevator with innovation fixtures and an old elevator with Otis Black buttons. And now to a parking garage right beside the Buffalo Metropolitan Center, where they have some Dover Impulse attractions.